So Chico, we were talking about Goa in the 1960s, and my family came back from Brazil of all places, and it was a very fast changing Goa. We didn't realize how fast it was changing. But what I wanted to ask you is, what was the nature of the music then? Did Portuguese, Latin influenced Goan music change suddenly, or was it a slow process of phasing out?
To be precise, as far as I know, music at Portuguese time, there was a program called Renaissance.
Renaissance continued on All India Radio till the 80s, 90s, but it was a shadow of itself, I guess.
It was a hit at that time.
Friday night?
It was on Friday night.
I see.
Friday. And it was such a hit that all type of music was broadcast.
Latin influenced?
Yeah.
Portuguese?
Portuguese, more Brazilian. One of these is this.
Yeah.
Costa Cabeci. Yeah. Then others. Brazilian, then it was a mixed cocktail like.
Okay.
Of music.
Run by whom?
And there was request. There was request. Also.
Who was the RJ? Who was the radio? Who was the announcer for the program?
The program was Imelda.
Imelda was an English announcer, no?
No, in Portuguese also.
Portuguese also.
Yes,
okay.
She was very top in the Portuguese.
Yeah.
It was very, and it was such a sweet voice. Everybody used to open the.
She was very popular.
There was no, mobile and all.
Yeah, no distractions.
Just go put the radio and Philips with the radio.
Radio was king and Philips was the king of radios.
Yeah, Philips was a book.
Yeah.
Philips radio. So much, there is a joke of our theatrist, Jasit Vaj.
Yeah.
You know, his wife was hammering him to send some radio Akai. Vishnu was fed up. Write to your brother, because he's in Dubai. He said, okay, I will write. Then, upon Buddha, I don't know, 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 I don't put an end there. Don't Nakai.
So Akai was a brand and Nakai means we don't want it. Okay.
I don't want.
So radio was extremely popular, and I think CMM and other companies like that were the importers of these radios.
Importers were CMM, Kakulos.
No, so what I'm saying, till...
And Wernicke.
Wernicke. Till 1961, imports were free and unregulated, and then when we became part of India, I mean the restrictions on imports came in.
Then others started.
And there were Indian productions also.
Very much.
Yes. I know Dalal used to produce radios in Mapsa, assemble radio stations.
Yes.
Big ones, very big ones. Yes. The size of a suitcase in that sense.
Then Neogis also used to bring some.
Yeah.
Indirectly.
Okay.
Because he was indulging always in the
importing
left hand side.
Okay. But in that sense, you were influenced by radio.
Yeah.
What else? Performances?
Mainly by radio, because that was the only thing.
Yeah.
Then came the cassettes.
Yeah.
Cassette.
Maybe.
Then I studied Fadu. I studied through cassette.
I see.
And especially cassette from Fadu Coimbra.
I see.
And also.
Sent from abroad?
I had a friend who had sent me this CD
of
Coimbra from abroad. Because it was very rare.
It must have been complicated because India and Portugal had no diplomatic relations till 1974.
He had said with one boy,
yeah,
a friend of ours, who was studying in Coimbra.
Okay.
In Portugal.
So he would bring it and come down?
Yeah.
Okay.
He had said, I can sing you one for the poem.
Yeah, but no, before that, I remember that in those days, there were still the last influences of the, not last, but some of the fading influences of the Portuguese weddings, the grand weddings,
the
soups and all the Portuguese food and the Portuguese plants.
All weddings were there, but more in vogue were marches.
Marches.
The frizzings.
I see.
Then marches like...
These marches were performed at the weddings or?
Wedding.
Okay. And one of the songs I remember which was played a lot was Encosta Tua Cabecinha, Lay Your Head on My Shoulder, which is a Brazilian love song from what I understand. But in Goa it had a different connotation because it's a very sad song, a song of departure, a song of demise.
Yeah, but most in vogue at the time of the march, Kajizaza.
Yeah. So those songs have remained with us for last 40, 30, 40, 50 years, and still
even now
when it's like almost we are stuck in a time warp now.
Yes, yes.
The music has, of course,
even now
in some of the events, like when Fundasam Orient organizes the the music song contest for youngsters, you get new songs, but otherwise it's the old ones. Can you sing Encosta for us and tell us a bit about the song?
Which song would you like to
sing? Encosta Tua Cabecinha.
Encosta tua cabecinha, o meu ombro chora, e conta logo tua mágoa toda para mim. Quem chora no meu ombro, juro, não vai embora, não vai embora, não vai embora. Encosta tua cabecinha no meu ombro, chora, e conta logo tua mágoa toda para mim.
Very sad, very touching, very haunting. No?
A old song. Then there is a continuation for it. E gostaria de minha cabecinha, teu ombro, eu chorei. It's a reply.
I see.
You know how this song came into picture?
How?
No?
No.
A couple, a boy and a girl, they're traveling from Rio de Janeiro to the new capital, São Paulo.
Ah.
In the bargain, she was sitting at the back.
Yeah.
And he was on the front. She saw this boy, very sad, sobbing. She called him and said, "Sit here. What is wrong with you? What happened?" A typical Latin attitude.
Yeah.
He explained. And it was a love lost, like, you know,
yeah.
He was remembering, but she said, "Nothing really. You have a sleep. Your eyes, this and that. And,
yeah.
And you can lean on
lay
my
your
shoulder.
Head on my shoulder."
Then they start to hold.
I see. I was quite intrigued by the song and I checked it out on the net, and there are many versions of
it. This is the story.
Yeah, yeah. And it became a hit. It became a hit in Brazil. And it's still, in any Portuguese context in Goa, it is still sung. Thank you.